structure. You're giving your client an option. You're giving your client information. It is up to client whether he or she chooses to run, to do treadmill, or to do just cardio. That could be cycling as well. So you are select, you have that knowledge, you have that frame, and you're delivering that frame, that structure to your client. And again, it is up to client how he or she chooses to go through the path of losing weight. And here with our training, we give you that structure. And it is a huge, huge attention that we are focusing on for quite a few months is competencies. And I would always say that it's quite equal to that structure, competencies, on top of mentoring, support, supervision, and everything else. So you are, throughout the training, given opportunity to present your skills, and then a professional trainer, such as PCC or MCC, is watching you perform and is tweaking your approach, not necessarily telling you you are not doing it right or you're doing it wrong. No, they're just carving the shape of your coaching, if that makes sense.
That's beautifully saying, carving the shape, because there is every one of you, if you would decide to be a coach, will be so different, because every one of you has a different style, different, you know, what's the word I'm looking for? Tatiana, help me. You know, style and personalities, right? We say coach is working with their personality, and each of you have such a different personality. So you'll be like very different coaches, even though you will be helping people, you will be working in your own way. But having certain framework, as Tatiana said, through adhering to competency, understanding how you act as a coach. So when you understand that, you will have no questions like, okay, what am I going to do here? What am I going to say? What's next? Because you'll be relaxing into that space, and you'll have the same, you'll kind of transfer the same confidence to your client, if I may say. So let's see, we have 19 more minutes. So let's see if we can have more questions. Adrian, I see you having a hand on. Would you like to go ahead?
Yes, thank you, Katya. So good morning from the Philippines. The time now in our country is 1:42 a.m. So
God bless you.
Thank you for for being considerate of the time of the different time zones. And I believe that part of the reason why the other registrants were not able to make it is because maybe they forgot to convert the time from the published time on the advertisement. On behalf of all the participants from the countries represented here, thank you guys to Coaching Up team for organizing this. And accommodation is also proper for whoever created your Facebook ad, because it worked really well. It reached out so many people from different countries. Now, I just want to support your answer earlier, and Tatiana, in relation to that very intriguing set of slides you showed with the checkpoints, still in regard to why tools are not to be heavily relied on when coaching people. So this is already my third coaching certification that I'm getting. Another one is international, and the other one is in our country. And what I learned from those certification programs is that the reason why we should not heavily rely on tools when we're coaching people is we should be asking more probing questions instead and draw the wisdom out of the person. Because I don't know if you guys have heard this, but even Brené Brown says this, that the shortcut of our brain processes is our gut. So our gut stores up the movement, the bodily reactions to so many challenges we've gone through all through our life. And so we should be able to draw out the wisdom from within the person by asking questions. Then the next, just a couple of things that I want to share with you guys. I understand that Katya was having difficulty earlier determining who raised their hands first.
Oh, so yeah, sorry.
I just to help you with this, I noticed that the first person who raised his hand or her hand is actually the one on the leftmost if you're using the speaker view. And then if you see after after I've spoken, the next person should be Oyerinde, and then David. And then it moves on. It moves
on.
Got
it. Okay. Thank you. I appreciate it, because sometimes, you know, my picture is changing a bit. So, but right. I appreciate your hint. I will definitely do that. Thank you.
Just one other suggestion in relation to the Q&A. I attended a webinar before, and what they did is they actually activated the Q&A so that all of the questions at the end of the webinar are attended to, or even another person who's co-hosting with you can also already answer this without everyone actually seeing the questions being posed. So just that, thank you for your time once again. And I'm learning a lot, not only to Tatiana and to you, Katya, but also to our fellow attendees here. Thank you once again.
Thank you, Adrian, for your kind words. Really appreciate it. Yeah, so sweet of you and so kind. And I want to just highlight a few of the words that you said about this is exactly the reason why you don't want to use tools, because you understand if the person came up with this problem, then they should be able to come out of it, right? And so that's the idea behind it. And when you coach, you really talk to people on many different levels. So you are talking about their thinking process. You're talking about their feeling process. You're talking about the intuition process, the energy process. So you really connect with the person on so many different levels. Sometimes the thinker comes to you and cannot solve certain problems. And the problem, the reason they can't solve this problem because they continue kind of pondering that problem with their thinking mind. And the answer might be in their feelings or in their gut, right? So as a coach, you help them to connect to different parts of those that maybe they're not really listening to. So thank you for bringing that up, Adrian. I really, beautiful, beautiful note. And yes, I'll follow your advice and I'll ask Oyerinde. I hope I pronounced the name correctly. Please go ahead.